800 boxes, 800 ideas. And they're all to do with him, Elmar Mok. He's turned inventing into an art form. Even though his first great invention is lying in one of the lower boxes, that doesn't make it any the less spectacular. When the Swiss watch industry was having problems, Elmar Mok reinvented the wristwatch. He came up with the Swatch. The special trick was the use of a new material for a watch, plastic. The idea, having fewer separate components, would make the whole thing cheaper. With his colleague Jacques Müller, he set to work. Müller had the watchmaking expertise, while engineer Mok was skilled in plastics processing and ultrasonic welding. To achieve the objective, new technologies had to be introduced to minimize work stages and to create far more complex forms. In other words, we used plastic to make not only the movement, but also the case. That way, the quality was sharply increased and the price sharply reduced. The development work at the watch company ITA was top secret. The two inventors melted and combined watch components. The result, a timepiece made of just 51 parts, instead of around double that amount. But the cheap watch wasn't immediately popular. Everyone was against it. They said it was a promotional item at best, and that surely no Swiss product could ever be made of plastic. What a cheap watch, they said. And they also believed that a watch that couldn't be repaired was a bad thing. There again, if it can't be repaired, then its quality has to be that much better. Countless designs were added, all fully in line with the trends of the 1980s. It was a triumph for the Swiss watch industry. But for Mok, the pioneer, this success took a lot of the fun out of it. For a chaotic person like myself, it was a wonderful time. But then the success of Swatch suddenly brought in order, structure, rules and systems that made me feel uncomfortable. So I wanted to get back into innovation again. And so it was that the Swatch didn't mark the end of his inventing career, but the beginning of it. Many people think that delving more deeply into what you already know brings novelty. I feel that you have to be curious, you have to see other things, you have to be inspired by nature, technology or people. You can't find mushrooms on a motorway. But inspiration isn't enough on its own. You also have to discover the benefits behind it. A tree in the ground seems to be very stable, but the earth with the tree inside it is not so stable. However, the tree's roots, its fractal connection with the soil, give it very high stability. Mok recognized this potential and adapted it to plastic. Injected into a porous substrate and liquefied using ultrasound, it solidifies within a fraction of a second inside the pores. Like the roots, the connection holds and no screws are needed. This so-called welding works with wood, plastic, and even with bone, enabling ultra-gentle operating techniques. Air, soap, water, and a further gentle application. That's what Mok focused on in his next big area of research. It saves resources, but not at the expense of hygiene. Smixin is the name of his new hand-washing machine. The objective was to use less water. Today you need a lot of water because you have to rinse. And during rinsing, you dissolve the soap that's concentrated on your hands. This enables me to dose the volume of soap and the volume of water precisely. So the whole hand-washing process can be done with only this amount of water. Normally you need 1 to 1.5 liters. The smart mixing unit saves 90% water and 60% soap. The device doesn't need a water supply, it's mobile, so it can be placed anywhere. One core invention, many applications. That's typical of the all-rounder Mok. The most economical shower will use up only 2 instead of 8 liters in the future. Tests are already underway. The future lies in information technology. The inventor is certain of that. I see a big future in optical sensors. Like our eyes, they need to be mobile and they need to be able to adapt. In smartphones, his mini motor has already been installed, a tiny drive that focuses incredibly quickly in the macro range. But my most important contribution to the world of inventions is this here, a collection of professional inventors, the Crayaholic. And this is really my life's work. Creativity and workaholism. The name says it all. Have ideas, take them seriously, try them out together, and work on an equal footing. Mock founded his creative collective, as he terms it, in 1986. With a workshop, kitchen, or office, everything is a creative space for the approximately 55 employees. I have great colleagues here. They really are very creative people. And a wolf needs a pack. You can't do much on your own. You can do far more in a team. So this bundling together of skills and also expertise enables us to transcend our own limits. That's why a team like this is important. Elmar Mock's magic formula has worked. He's created numerous startups, along with jobs, as a result of all his inventions. 178 patent families bear his name. An incredible output for a 30-year-long inventing career.